destination has led us to our final day.
I know. I'm kind of sad, Carmen. What about you?
I am too. I am really sad.
In our first dig, we discovered Jesus came as God promised. Our next destination led us to how Jesus demonstrated God's power.
And as we kept on digging, we discovered how Jesus was betrayed and rejected.
And now we have our final destination. We will learn how Jesus died and rose again.
We hope you have learned a lot during these 3 days. We have received so much information about the gift God gave us in His Son, Jesus.
We all can receive this special gift. If you would like to receive this gift of salvation, text the number at the bottom of your screen for more information. See you guys next year.
Every time I turn around, blessings, blessings. Every time I turn around, blessings on blessings. Every time I turn around, blessings, blessings. Every time I turn around, blessings on blessings. Yeah. Blessings, blessings. Yeah. blessings. There will be blessings on blessings. Blessings, blessings.
We made it to the last day of Vacation Bible School. What an amazing week we have had learning all about Jesus. I am Miss Carmen, and I have been your teacher all week. Today is Vacation Bible School Day 4. Our theme for this year is Destination Dig. Our scripture comes from Jeremiah 29 and 13. And ye shall seek me and find me when ye shall search for me with all your heart. And that is exactly what we have been doing this week. Our lesson for today is Jesus is alive. All you'll need for today is your Bible and your activity book. Are you ready to get started? All you have to do is open your brains up and get ready to learn. Before we start, let's go to God in prayer. Dear God, thank you for bringing us all the way to the last day of Vacation Bible School. God, we thank you for our pastor. We thank you for all of the members. God, we thank you for the boys and girls who are watching us on today. Thank you for teaching us more about you and more about Jesus. God, we thank you for this lesson because we know it's going to be amazing. God, we love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for praying that prayer with me. Let's get started with our lesson. The title of today's lesson is Jesus is Alive. God told prophets that Jesus would be born. God also told them how Jesus would be punished for our sins. And we have already learned that this week. The prophets also said that Jesus would die with the wicked, be buried with the rich, and be raised from the dead. All of this seemed too amazing to be true. But Jesus fulfilled every single prophecy. Jesus was crucified between two criminals. When Jesus knew he had completed everything he had to do, he said, "It is finished." Then he died. Joseph, a wealthy man, asked to take care of Jesus' body. Joseph and Nicodemus took great care to prepare Jesus' body and place it in a brand new tomb Jesus had just had made. Then they rolled a stone across the opening to seal the tomb. Early on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb to complete the burial rituals. When she got there, the stone was removed and Jesus was gone. Mary ran to tell the disciples. Peter and John raced to the tomb and looked inside. The burial clothes were there, but Jesus was not. They believed what they saw, but they still couldn't understand. Mary stood outside the tomb crying. She saw someone there, but she thought he was a gardener. The man said, "Mary." Immediately, Mary knew it was Jesus. She was overjoyed. She couldn't wait to tell the disciples. "I have seen the Lord," she said. "He is alive." What an amazing story. This brings everything all together. Jesus was born. Jesus healed. Jesus died. And now Jesus is alive. I enjoyed that story so much, boys and girls, because that is the point. Jesus died for our sins, but he is yet still alive. All right, are you guys ready for some discussion questions? We want to make sure that everybody understood the lesson. Are you ready? Give me a thumbs up. All right, right. Thank you for those thumbs. All right. Number one. Jesus never did anything wrong. Do you think that was difficult for Jesus, or was it easy for Jesus? Think about yourself. Is it easy for you to do something wrong? Sometimes we do things wrong even when we know they are wrong. It is always important to do the right thing. Good job, guys. All right, you ready for the next one? Okay, number two. How can we show Jesus that we are grateful for what he did on the cross? How can we show Jesus that we are grateful for what he did on the cross? Good question. We can show Jesus that we are grateful by following his commands, doing what he said to do. That means being kind to others. That means obeying your parents. That means obeying your teachers. That means telling the truth. That means doing what is right, just like Jesus did. Oh, you guys are so smart. Okay, one last question. Are you ready? Okay. When Jesus died on the cross, he took the punishment for our sins so we could have forgiveness. How do we receive this gift? I'll say it again. When Jesus died on the cross, he took the punishment for our sins so we could have forgiveness. How do we receive this gift? We receive this gift by confessing our sins, that we are not perfect, but we're trying to be perfect. How can you receive this gift? By admitting that you are a sinner and by repenting. By believing that Jesus is the Son of God who came and died on the cross for your sins. And by confessing that Jesus is your Lord and Savior. If you would like to have this very special gift, I want you to type your name to the number at the bottom of the screen. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for this amazing lesson that taught us that Jesus died and rose again, and he is yet still alive. Thank you for all of our friends who are watching, who wants to accept the gift, the most amazing gift that we could ever receive. God, I thank you for Vacation Bible School. What an amazing week we have had learning about you and learning about Jesus. God, I thank you, and I thank you, and I thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, you know what time it is. Let's get ready for a cool craft. All right, guys, we are ready for our prayer journals. Now, we have to pop our balloon to see what we're going to be writing about. Go grab your prayer journals. If you don't have one, no worries at all. Just get some notebook paper or plain white paper to write. Okay, are you guys ready? Countdown and 3, 2, 1. Let's see what we're going to be writing about on today. Has there ever been a time when you felt betrayed? Look at the birds in the tree. Amazing, God's creation. Because Jesus, by Keon Jackson. If you're going to follow God, wear comfortable shoes. Mission, love unconditionally. Be somebody's blessing. Don't just sit around. There is love to be loved.
He rose. Jesus rose from the dead. What a great message, and what a great reminder that Jesus Christ did exactly what he said he was going to do. We can trust in the fact that Jesus Christ is Lord and Savior because he rose from the dead. Look, if you want to know more about this Christ who died in our place for our sins but rose from the dead, please have your parents text the number below so we can help you understand why that is so important for our lives. God, we thank you that you are faithful to your promises and the fact that you rose from the dead with all power. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank you so much for tuning in to VBS this year. We pray that God has really used this in your life. See you next time.